Roger, Houston, do you have some high gain angles for Columbia, over?
Roger, Eagle and Columbia, stand by. We'll have them for you shortly. Eagle, Houston, could you verify you switched lithium hydroxide canisters, over?
That's affirmative. We started getting an erratic indication on primary, so we switched to secondary and it was again erratic, and I thought it might have been a sensor, but it's settled down now, and we're on the secondary, over.
Roger, we copy, mighty fine. Columbia and Eagle, request Omni Delta for Columbia.
Houston, Columbia's been on Delta, but he hasn't had much luck with you.
Eagle, Houston, Roger, we copy.
This is Apollo Control. Columbia is now in an orbit measuring 56.6 nautical miles by 62.5 nautical miles, and the displays here in Mission Control show the range from Eagle to Columbia of a tad over 100 nautical miles and about 99 feet per second closure rate.
We'd like to go ahead and try your lithium hydroxide on the primary and let us take a look at it down here. Columbia, Houston, over.
Houston, Eagle, Columbia's been reading you loud and clear on
on his omnis, but he hasn't had any luck in transmitting to you.
Roger, Eagle, mighty fine. We don't hear Columbia, though.
Okay.
R's, Mike, minus 1.8.
Eagle Houston, Columbia, Houston, Columbia, Houston, over. Columbia, Houston, you can go ahead and go to REAC in the high gain. We should get you then.
Angle for him, Houston?
Roger, pitch, minus 30,
and
yaw, 180 for Columbia.
Okay, and what was your CDA solution, Mike?
Four.
Houston Eagles. Got an EPS light and a CO2 light. Partial pressure is reading about 0.5 millimeters.
Eagle in Columbia, Houston Rugby, copy. Houston, go. Eagle, Houston, we're sure that's a sensor problem. You can leave it on primary.
Okay.
Roger, we pull the circuit breaker.
Roger, Eagle.
And our water separator apparently isn't working too well. We're getting a lot of water through the suit loop, and we've changed water separators, but doesn't seem to have improved the situation any.
Eagle Houston, Roger, we copy. Eagle Houston, for warm fueling, we are agreeing with your CDH.
Congratulations. Unfortunately, the chart didn't agree with it because the range rate at 36 minutes was off the chart.
Apollo Control here. Less than a minute remaining until the constant delta height, or CDH, maneuver. We'll continue to monitor the air ground. This is a small magnitude radial burn to put Eagle in a orbit that's concentric with... Here we go, 30 seconds.
Burn complete.
Thank you.
Eagle Houston, when you get a chance, are your LCGs hooked up? And if so, what does the LCG accumulator show?
This is Apollo Control, range now showing 91.3 nautical miles. Range rate, range of closure, 119 feet per second.
It sure is great to look down there and not see ya.
Good day.
Eagle, Houston.
Go ahead.
Roger, did you copy on the LCG there and reading on the water accumulator?
Yeah. It's... Roger, I did. I'm getting out of pressure. Houston, the water accumulator is right on the line between the red and the green. Over.
Eagle, Houston, roger, we copy. Eagle, Houston.
Houston, Eagle.
Roger, on the water problem there. We can't add anything more to it except the fact that it looks like the water accumulators are up to speed to us down here.
Okay, it's not going to be too much trouble.
Roger, fine.
Just, it's in one suit, too, for some reason.
Columbia, Houston, our comm problem was traced to a ground station here.
Oh, good, glad to hear it.
Roger, you're mighty fine now. Thank you.
This is Apollo Control. Range between Eagle and Columbia now showing 67.5 nautical miles. Range rate, closure rate, 121 feet per second.
Range rate is 30.
I have a TPI TIG when you guys want to compare them.
Stand by. Mike, what do you got?
127.02.3450.
You're about 32 seconds later than we are.
Okay, fine.
This is Apollo Control, some 25 minutes now until the TPI terminal phase initiation burn, just before loss of signal, as both spacecraft go over the hill. This is Apollo Control. The black team of flight controllers here in Mission Control are more or less in an advisory capacity during this rendezvous sequence. They're actively computing maneuver times, but in the final analysis, it's onboard computations by the crew of Columbia and Eagle, which really bring about the rendezvous. Standing by at 126 hours, 37 minutes, ground elapsed time. Some 24 minutes away from ignition on the thrust along the line of sight for terminal phase initiate.
Do you want to get another? All right, get a data update. Thanks. Early touches. Market. Range. read in. Our brain fade at 40.
Buzz, I'd like to confirm that your TPI TIG is 127.0202, over.
We haven't settled on a final one yet. The last one was, standby. Okay, latest estimate 127.03.39.
Thank you, Kyle.
Eagle, Houston.
Roger, go ahead.
Roger. In the event of the possibility that we may have had some water channeling in those hydroxide canisters, we recommend you stay in the cabin mode from now on. Over.
Roger.
Eagle, Houston.
Go ahead.
Roger, I better clarify the cabin mode a little bit there. What I mean is you go ahead and stay in the cabin mode. Helmets and gloves on are your option. And we really have no concern with the CO2. Over.
Roger, understand.
Mike, you already loaded that time. We got a final one here.
I've already loaded it. I don't think it'll make much difference.
It's only 9 seconds difference.
Mach 6.
Columbia, Houston.
Columbia, go ahead.
Roger, Mike, you can go ahead and arm your logic anytime you want to, and we'll give you a go so that you can hit your power alarm at your convenience.
That's a good idea, babe. You standing by to watch logic?
Affirmative. Give us a mark.
Mark logic one. Mark logic two.
Columbia, Houston, we need the sex arm circuit breakers closed.
Okay, going in, sex arm bat A and bat B.
Columbia, Houston, logic looks good. You can arm your pyros at your convenience.
Thank you. Eagle, Columbia is starting to maneuver to TPI engine.
Okay.
This is Apollo Control, about 6.5 minutes to ignition on the terminal phase maneuver, in which the crew of Eagle will thrust along the line of sight toward Columbia. Distance now between the two spacecraft, some 38.6 nautical miles, closing at a rate of 110 feet per second.
All your solutions look good to us. Out.
Yeah, Mike, if you want our target delta V, I'll give it to you.
Ready, copy.
127.03.3082. 20 plus 22.7 plus 1.7 minus 10.6. Over.
127.03.3082 plus 22.7. Plus 1.7, minus 10.6, thank you.
I'm showing a good bit out of plane velocity on my crossfinders, Mike.
Roger, I have no indication of it. Coming up on 1 minute to take, Neil, how's it looking?
Pretty good.
Good.
That data plane was in the egg, not in the radar.
Roger that.
Control. We've apparently had loss of signal with Columbia and Eagle as they went behind the moon on the 26th revolution. Next maneuver scheduled for about 33 minutes from now. While both vehicles are behind the moon, this will be the braking series of maneuvers coming down to docking. Station keeping first and then docking at about 128 hours around elapsed time. And at 127 hours, 6 minutes around elapsed time in the flight of Apollo 11. This is Mission Control.
I can't see you, Michael. Okay, you try getting it on total. I haven't been. You want me to? No, I can keep the chart. Thank you. for Theta 12. Okay. All over the back. Sorry, I'm Still got it? Probably won't with the first gift, did I? No, that's good. Okay.
No,
no,
now I can't see.
What's that?
No, no, it's a gift lock.
They're coming right down the bad of him, if they were doing it at night.
Okay, I just lost sight of him, a sunliner. Well, I got it. I got him now, too. Sure done. Data bags around there. I may have one or two of my temporary stowage, right? We may want them in addition to the other regular bags, so we put them in a data bag in it.
Data bag?
Yeah, there are a couple of different lamp bags that I left in there. One of those two bright spots is bound to be blank. How about picking the closest one? Good idea. About that lake, get to the your tracking light. Full vehicle shows. You can see that you're pointed at me. Now you're turning a little bit. Great. 140 centimeters we thought of. That's not bad at all. The horizon was pretty dicey. That was just lucky. Okay, let's put C-47 in. Okay, we're getting it. 11 feet a second coming in, engine.
This is Apollo Control, 127 hours, 50 minutes, ground elapsed time. Less than a minute now away from acquisition of the spacecraft Columbia. Hopefully you flying within a few feet of it will be Eagle. Docking should take place about 10 minutes from now, according to the flight plan. However, this is a crew option matter. We're standing by for word that data is coming in from the two spacecraft. This is Lunar Revolution number 27 for Columbia.
Roger.
Okay, Mike, I'll try to get position here, and then you got it. How did the roll attitude look?
Eagle Houston, Middle Gimbal, and you might pass the Columbia. We don't have him yet.
That's right.
platform, Greg. Okay?
I'm not going to do a thing, Mike. I'm just letting her hold that and you know.
Okay, we're all yours. Columbia.
Okay.
Houston, go.
Roger, I'm supposed to adjust the oxygen flow in this thing to 0.6 pounds per hour, but being as how this transducer is not working right, can you give me an updated number?
Affirmative, you want to go ahead and adjust your O2 flow until it just goes off the peg, and then crank the direct O2 valve back down about 5 degrees, over.
Roger,
that's fine. That's what we expect. Columbia, Houston, I have a new limb wait for you whenever you're ready to copy. Apollo 11, that's okay, we'll get it later.
This is Apollo Control. Communications are somewhat scratchy with Apollo 11. Columbia and Eagle now reunited to become Apollo 11 again. Our best estimate on the time of docking is some 3 minutes after the pre-mission time of 128 hours. Continuing to monitor this 27th lunar orbit where the two-way communications between the two spacecraft.
Kevin, go ahead with your tap cloud, please.
Roger, your LEM weight 5785. For an R1, we'd like to have 61102. R2 0111. Use BD roll. Over.
Roger, I'm configured now with 10-8 for BD roll, and I have thruster C4 and B3 turned off, and I copy register 1, 61102, 01111, and LEM weight 5785. Thank you.
Roger, Columbia. after doing a leak check, missed anything after that? Or Columbia, roger.
Okay.
Control. Still rather noisy communications here on the 27th Lunar Revolution. 39 minutes remaining until Apollo 11 goes behind the moon. We'll leave the circuit up and try to monitor the conversation between the two spacecraft or between Apollo 11 and the ground for the remainder of this pass. Try to ascertain the status on board as far as transferring the crew and other items back into the command module. The cleanup in the limb, getting all the items dusted off prior to bringing them back into the command module. At 128 hours, 25 minutes ground elapsed time and standing by, this is Apollo Control.
Yeah, everything's going fine. Be with you in a sec.
Eagle, Houston, over.
ahead, Houston Eagle here.
Roger. Anytime prior to jettison there, we'd like an ag for things aligned, 400 plus 30,000. Over.
Okay. Any particular attitude you'd like the things in when you do that?
Course align, gimbal angle to move the things to, and then we'll align the ag to the things, over. Roger, Eagle, we concur, stand by on the gimbal angles. And also, Eagle, while we've got the command module direct O2 on there, there's a possibility that your cabin relief might relieve if we get on up around cabin pressure of about 5.4 or 5.5. Eagle, Houston.
Roger, go ahead.
Roger, all we're trying to do is get things and ags aligned together. It doesn't make any difference on the gimbal angle. Beautiful.
Now you might want to take into account what will happen in the CSM maneuver to jettison attitude.
Eagle, Houston, we don't care what all we're trying to do is get a drift rate or see how long it takes them to drift apart on the thing after you jettison.
Okay, will we be jettisoning in about this attitude? That's okay, I'll align the ag to the thing. You can tell me a little later if you need some help.
Hey, Eagle Houston, that's fine.
high gain or anything like that?
Columbia, Houston, I can give you some react angle for the high gain on the limb jettison attitude, and you can go there whenever you want to. The angles are pitch minus 50 and yaw 0. Columbia, Houston, roll 0, pitch 025, and yaw 0. Over.
Roger, understand. Roll 0, pitch 025, yaw 0.
Affirmative.
Houston Eagle, over.
Now Eagle, Houston, go.
Roger, it doesn't appear as though the red hose is going to be much of a competitor to the leading vacuum cleaner brands, over.
There's a little noise there, Buzz, there again. Eagle Houston.
Roger, go ahead.
Roger, just a reminder to be sure and zero the AGS errors before you enable AGS attitude hold there after you get in burn attitude.
Roger, mean step attitude.
Hey, Columbia, Houston, mighty fine, loud and clear.
Yeah, same here, Ron, thanks.
And Eagle, Houston, your steerable antenna angle for jettison attitude R. Over.
Roger, go ahead.
Roger, pitch 165, yaw 68. Over.
Roger, pitch 165, yaw 68.
Eagle Houston, correct. Columbia, Houston.
Columbia, go ahead.
Roger, Mike. You want to tweak the O2 flow up just a bit there.
Okay, coming up. Houston, do you have any preferences as to what you want us to do with the probe? Over.
Columbia, Houston, stand by one.
Okay, Eagle says they've got a place for it inside there, so no problem.
Roger, that's all we were assuming. Eagle Houston.
Eagle, go ahead.
Roger, Neil. Looks like your steerable is good. You can put your track mode to slew and high bit rate, please. Over.
Okay, track mode to slew and high bit rate.
Eagle, Houston.
Go ahead, Houston.
Roger, Neil. Just a reminder again, ACA out of detent to zero the ags there, just in case you go to attitude hold shortly.
Okay.
Thank you.
Eagle, Houston.
Houston Eagle, go ahead.
Roger, that ACA out of detent didn't quite do it because the mode control switches were off. Request guidance control to pings and then back to ags. That'll zero the ags there. Over.
Say again, please.
Roger, request guidance control switch to pings and then back to ags. Over.
Okay, we still have both mode control switches off. Over.
That's okay. That's good.
And I thought I'd just take about 5 seconds here and see if I could get 000 gone. Since we're fairly close to gimbal lock right now.
Eagle, Houston, that's fine.
This is Apollo Control. Some 6 minutes 40 seconds remaining until Apollo 11 goes behind the moon on the 27th revolution. The signal from the passive seismometer, which was left on the moon by the crew of Eagle, was lost for 30 minutes, beginning about 5 minutes before Eagle took off this morning. The signal was lost because of an equipment problem at the Canary Island tracking station. The seismic equipment is back online now and is beginning to record lunar day surface temperatures. The dust detector recorded zero dust after Eagle liftoff. The laser ground stations have not yet acquired a return signal from the laser ranging retro reflector. 5 minutes away from loss of signal with Apollo 11, we'll continue to monitor the air ground as the spacecraft goes over the hill. The crew now is engaged in the decontamination procedures inside the lunar module prior to transferring back into the command module.
In about 5 minutes to LOS. Your limjet time will be 131 plus 52, and I have the rest of the maneuver pad if you want it now, or I can give it to you on the next time around.
Next time around, please.
Sure, my back, that's fine. We'll get it to you then.